Oh, this is Maddie Brown, and I am a CPA that is totally against budgeting and all in favor of financial freedom for entrepreneurs to have the life that they want to live and the business that supports that life. So most people go into business for themselves because they want financial freedom. They want to live the life that they are dreaming of. And when you're in business for yourself, a lot of people think that they're going to be able to do whatever they want to do whenever they want to do it. And then they find out that their business runs the show and they lose the life that they actually set out to gain. If you're good at what you do and you need to feel in control of your financial life, then this is the place to start. It is a workshop to look at the five steps that there are to actually creating the financial life that you want to have. One of the things that I hate to see in this world is that there's over 12 million women-owned businesses in this country. And of those 12 million, 88% of them are making less than $100,000 a year. And less than 2% of them are grossing more than $1 million. So that leaves a lot of people that are not making the money that they need to make to support the lives that they want to live. And I want to see that 88% number that are making less than 100K reduced, because that is the backbone of our economy. I've been working with small businesses for 40 years. It's my passion to help them create the financial freedom that they went into business to get. If you're not having fun, then it's not something that you should be doing. You need to make certain. I've been in dark, deep places in my life, and life is too short to not be able to say that I love what I do and I'm making a difference in people's lives. That particular statement has served me very well over the course of my life. And if I maintain that focus, things go very well. So I always have that mantra. I love what I do and I'm making a difference in people's lives. It breaks my heart to see small business owners struggle with money. And I see a lot of small business owners that are making $10,000, $15,000, $20,000 a year net. And if they were working at McDonald's, they would make more money. It is a travesty to see small business owners put in 60, 80-hour weeks and not make the money that they need to make in the world. And they make more money flipping hamburgers than McDonald's. So Smashing Numbers is a new generation CPA firm that offers small business consulting, coaching. We do bookkeeping, we do accounting, and of course we do taxes. And we work virtually with clients all over the United States. My passion is working with small business owners. And I do mean small business owners, the solo entrepreneurs, the people that are working and doing a one-man show. I want to see them do better in the world. So I want to say that you can have fun creating a profitable business that pays you first. You need to know what to do with the money that is coming in, even if you're feeling like you don't have enough. You need to know how to confidently make financial decisions. And you need to know how to pay the least in taxes and not have a rude awakening when your tax bill comes around in March. March is not the only time. March and April are not the only times to look at your finances and make decisions. You need to do that throughout the year. And in order to do that, you need accounting records. And we're going to talk about the next few steps to actually creating the business that you want to live. So my promise is that you will know the next steps to creating financial freedom by the end of this webinar. Thank you. Do you worry about running out of money? Are you worried about an IRS bill? Are you scared to invest money in your business? Are you stressed out about having the cash flow that you need? Do you wake up in the middle of the night worrying about paying off your debt? Do you check your bank balance daily because you don't know where you stand? Do those describe you? If they describe you, they describe a very large percentage of the solo entrepreneurs that are out there in this world. And I want these things to go away so that you can focus on your really good opportunity that your business provides for you. None of those things are the problem. The good news is, whatever it is, we can create a reality that your plan can be real. You can make what you desire and what you want be reality. You'll know about affording programs. You won't have stress and worry. You'll have something to show for your time. You'll get paid. You'll know that you're paying your taxes right. You'll know what your bills are and what you need to pay, and you'll know that you have them covered. Over the past 40 years, I have worked with literally thousands of small business owners. I've taught tax compliance. I have taught small business entrepreneurship. And I love working with people and seeing them have the success that they went into business in order to have. And I know that we can create realistic financial game plans that will give you the freedom that you want. Now, there are actually 5 steps that compromise what is a financial success plan to me. The first step in creating a life you love is knowing exactly what you want. There really is no more important question to answer than to know exactly what you want. If you know what you want, then you can make decisions and you can set goals and you can make sure that everything leads you to that end goal. You need to keep your eye on the prize. When you set a goal that says, I'm going to drive from New York to Los Angeles, you get out a map and you look at where you're going and you know the destination. You know you're going to be in Los Angeles. You probably know what you're going to do in Los Angeles, who you're going to talk to, what you're going to eat, what you want to see. All of those things in your vision of Los Angeles are things that you also need to have in your financial day-to-day business life. You need to have very clear vision of what it is you want. And so when I start working with people, the first question I ask them is, what do they want? What does an ideal day look like? What is it that is going to make you happy and joyful and feel successful? And that's where you start creating your business. Because if you create your business based upon a strictly financial goal, it's not going to reward you spiritually and mentally and emotionally, and it's not going to give you everything you want. So I'd like you to think about it like going into a restaurant. When I order a chef salad, I order a picky chef salad. I want chicken. I want eggs, I want bacon, I want cheese, I want lettuce, and I don't want ham, and I don't want onions, and I don't want olives. So I know what I want, I can order it up, and they will deliver me whatever it is that I say that I want. And that's the way life works. You have to create a vision, and you have to stick to it, so that it is what you really want. Now, the second step is you need to look at your history. Now, history is accomplished by looking at your bookkeeping, looking at your record keeping. The most important thing is that you get financial records every month for you to look at and review and see if you are still on target for that first event. If you're still, if you're meeting the goals that you set out in step one, is what you're doing taking you closer to those goals? So your bookkeeping reads like a storybook to me because it tells me what your priorities are. It tells me what you want in the world. It tells me how you make decisions. And all of those things are from your past. And so your bookkeeping is past performance, okay? It does not give you future. You still need to do forecasting, but it gives you an accurate accounting of what happened in the past so that you can make better decisions going further in the future. Bookkeeping is not just for taxes. A lot of people think that they need to get their bookkeeping done just so that they can do their tax return. And that's really not the way it works. You need the bookkeeping so that you can make financial decisions, so that you can operate your business profitably. It's not just for taxes. You need a monthly reporting system that gives you information you can compare to your goals so that you can be successful. Now, the next thing that I'm going to have you look at is your personal expenses, okay? Because the reality is if you're self-employed, your business needs to cover not only your business expenses, but it needs to cover your personal expenses. And so you need to look at, where do you want to live? What kind of house do you want to live in? What kind of car do you want to drive? All kinds of
I'm here. I'm personal things. Maddie Brown on her. She's in the.
There are all kinds of personal things that you want to do in your life, and you need to make sure that you have the bandwidth to do this. So the goals that you set out in step one should be personal and should be business. And you need to make certain that your business is going to support all of those goals. So if you want a massage once a week, you need to factor in $400 a month for the massage. And it's part of what you need to schedule for yourself as well as for your business. Then you need to look at your business expenses. Now, your business expenses are not just the business expenses from your bookkeeping, but you also need to look at your business goals. Because if you want to make $1 million a year, your business expenses are going to look very different than how they look if you are making $100,000 a year. There may be a virtual assistant, there may be a business manager, there may be a marketing person, and you've got to factor in all of those things that you want and not just the things that are on your past performance, because the past performance is not going to deliver you the future that you desire. You want to be maintaining your focus on the future that you desire, what you want it to be. Compare every month your business expenses from your bookkeeping to your targeted business expenses, your forecasting. And when you do that, then you can make good financial decisions going forward. The fifth thing is really the surprising thing to most people. I believe that you start at the bottom of the equation and you say, how much money do I want to have at the end of the day? At the end of the month, how much money do I want to have to show what I've done this month? And when you look at it, I want you to always apply 10% of everything you take in into a wealth account, into a savings account. Now, if 10% is too much for you right now, start with 5, start with 1, start with something and set up an account that you pay yourself into, a wealth account. And I want that to be 10%. I want you to set aside 20% for your taxes of everything that comes in. And then I want to add in your personal expenses, and I want to add in your business taxes, and your cash flow, the top line number, needs to meet all of those criteria. The top line number needs to pay for your business expenses. It needs to pay for your personal expenses. It needs to pay for your taxes, and it needs to pay for your savings. And so you work from the bottom back up and you reverse engineer how much money you need to make on a monthly basis. Now, I much prefer a forecasting model to a budgeting model. Forecasting involves identifying what you want and making the plans to create what it is you want on an ongoing basis. Budgeting means taking what you have and allocating it over whatever it is you need to spend money on. And that's really a very lack perspective. And the reality is that there is an abundant supply of money. There is more than enough money for everyone. You don't worry about there being enough air, because always air to breathe, and there's money to be had. It's a question of what you're willing to do to get it and what you need to do to get it and your understanding of mastering your money. If you got a $10,000 check today, do you know what to do with that money? Do you know where to put it? Do you know how to allocate it? And if you know the answer to that question, then you have a strategy for your taxes, you have a strategy for your debt, you have a strategy for savings, and you know that you can meet your personal and your business requirements. Now, that strategy is a financial success plan. Now, you're going to look at how many clients do I need to work with? Do I need to work with 10 clients at $1,000 a month or one client at $10,000 a month? I don't know the answer to that question. And it takes you full circle back to where we began, which is, what do you want? How do you want your life to look? How many days a week do you want to work? How many hours a week do you want to work? Do you want to do things remotely? All of those things factor into creating a financial success plan. And you need to reverse engineer back into what you need for cash flow in order to actually make the plan work. So it approaches it from the end. The end is where you want to be and what you want it to look like. And then you're going to have the financial freedom that you deserve. Because success, in my mind, is being able to make financial decisions without consulting the bank to see how much money there is in your checking account. I've worked with my private clients spending 60 days together, going through the process and getting everything on track for your business. And I found that there were a lot of folks that really needed support and needed help, and they were not in a financial position to go through the full 60 days to financial freedom. And so I created a program that I have been working on while I work with my clients for years. It works. I know it works. And it enables you to follow those same steps to create a plan. Now, the 60-day private program is a $3,000 investment. This do-it-yourself program is only $297. The address is Roadmap to Financial Success. It is a series of short videos and worksheets to work through the process and guide you to where you can create that financial success plan. And it includes videos and bonuses and a workbook and automated worksheets. And at the end of it, there is a debriefing call with one of my team to see where you are, what you need, and what your next steps need to be. So you can do all that for a $297 price point, which is affordable for every small business owner. And I want to offer you a discount code that you can use if you have signed up for this webinar called Client Success, and that will take $100 off of the process. So if you are interested, now is the time to do it. And I look forward to seeing you when you have the financial success that you really want to have.